The path to Ellis Island takes you past the Statue of Liberty and eventually over to Ellis Island, which is where we took our wonderful journey today.
Well, I walked over the bridge into the city where I live, and I saw my old landlord. Well, we both said hello, there was nowhere else to go, 'cause this rent I couldn't afford. Well, relationships change, though I think it's kind of strange how money makes a man grow. Or some people, they claim if you get enough fame, you live over the rainbow. Over the rainbow. But the people on the street, out on buses or on feet, we all got the same blood flow. Oh, in society, every dollar got a deed. We all need a place where we can go and feel over the rainbow. Sometimes we forget what we got, who we are, oh, and who we are not. I think we gotta change, make it right.
The difference between today at Ellis Island and yesteryear is not all that stark, and one can imagine how it all began.
I'm coming from a long line of pain. My family suffered greatly for my gain, and I think a lot about how my daddy died, so I would not live with that.
Over 100 million American men, women, and children came here between 1892 and 1954. Upon disembarking, immigrants were directed toward a large building where they immediately entered a gigantic 60-foot-high registry room. Here, they underwent a quick medical exam, followed by a review of their travel papers. Most cleared was processed within 5 hours and left for their ultimate destination the same day.
So once they figured out where they were going, they put gigantic tags on them telling the railroad, you bought your train ticket here at Ellis Island. And then they would give you a big sticker or like a tag on your jacket that told the conductor where you were supposed to go.
Becoming a citizen was exciting, and for those who had family elsewhere, they moved on from New York, but many stayed in Manhattan and dealt with the new life in the Lower East Side, a notorious area where the population was booming during these years, and not always for the better.
Like a dead man's rocking chair.
In 1990, Ellis Island was renovated and transformed into a museum dedicated to educating visitors about the immigrant experience. The building then had fallen into disrepair, and they've recommissioned much of it, retaining some of the original artifacts and putting them on display. You can spend about 2 hours or so walking around and seeing some of these items and just imagining the stories of some of these people who came through so desperate, with the hope of America in front of them.
Because my heart's in this song. When the melody comes, and just as quickly the melody is gone, I'm back alone, far.